What's up, everyone? It's Jonathan. Thank you for joining our distance learning assembly. I know this has been a crazy time for all of us, but I hope you guys are all doing well. Finish the year strong, and congrats to all the seniors. This assembly will start like every other assembly, and we'll just start it off with the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you, Jonathan. It was really good to hear from you. And Mayanna Robertson, you just did a beautiful job with the national anthem. We really appreciate it. Hi, I'm Mrs. Wiesman, and I am the activities director here at HRVHS. And I want to welcome you to our first ever distance learning assembly. Thank you so much for being here. Usually at this time, we would be doing some sort of game. And rather than doing a game, we're going to do something that many of you have been watching over your distance learning time and do some TikTok dancing. So sit back and enjoy. We have some pretty good TikTok dancers on the staff, and thank you so much, Jonathan and Cassandra, for letting us put your video up. All right, we want to get into some celebrations and some recognition, so we're going to let Mr. Kroll and Ms. Campos Davis take it over.
Hey, Eagles, how's it going? I'm Trent Kroll, your athletic director, and this is...
I'm Coach Sperry, teacher and coach.
We're here to give you the athletics update for this awesome virtual assembly. What a beautiful night here in Hood River County. Coach, we didn't have the winter sports awards assembly, so let's talk a little bit about our winter sports. Tell us a little bit about our men's basketball all-conference guys.
Yeah, so in men's basketball, we had honorable mention Ian Searcy and first team all-conference Noah Webster.
Tell us about our girls basketball all-conference.
So in women's basketball, we had honorable mention all-conference Grace Myers. Congratulations.
Woohoo! Our swim team did phenomenal this year.
Swim team.
Boys were second in conference, and girls won the IMC conference. We also had some state placers. Coach, tell us about our state placers for swimming.
Well, let's see. We had a state champion 200 free relay team made up of Clayton Lee, Luke Southall, Connor McElwee, and David Heskel.
Woohoo! I was there. It was awesome. And
And we had some runner-ups, Sarah Arpeg and David Heskel. And Luke Southall was a honorable mention all-state swimmer. Congratulations. Nice job.
Fantastic. Wrestling. I know a little bit about wrestling. We had two state placers, one girl, one guy. Freshman Lorraine Smith places at state, fourth in state. Woohoo! And Chad Munzer, senior, for the fourth time, second male in the history of the school to place 4 years in a row at wrestling. Congrats, Chad, and we're super proud of all of those people. Our alpine team, ski team did great. Our freestyle ski team did awesome. Our competitive cheer did great. Nordic ski was fun. Snowboard was fun as well. And the speech and debate ended up just missing, and they didn't get to do their state tournament either. So shout out to speech and debate. Okay, coach, let's talk about spring sports. We didn't get to do our spring sports.
It's terrible.
Oh my gosh.
Awful.
It's really, really traumatic. And we feel for all of you. However, we want to give a shout out to those seniors who would have been playing their fourth year or just starting as a senior. It doesn't matter. We want to give a shout out to those seniors. And I want you to take a look at them on the screen here as we talk about their names. Coach, tell us about the six baseball seniors.
All right, for baseball, our seniors were Brandon Dish, Derek Homer, Grayson Losey, Gunnar Hardy, Juan Luis Jimenez, and Ryan Gray. Coach, tell us about the senior golf athletes we had.
Golf? Hey, you know what? Faith Ocheski was going to do golf for the first time ever and be a three-sport athlete. She didn't get to do it, but we're going to shout out to Faith, who was going to help that golf team this year, and Logan Marquez, or Marks. For, I always say, Logan, I say your name wrong all the time, I apologize. For, as a male golfer, senior. Coach, tell us about the 12 lacrosse players, both male and female seniors.
Yeah, quite a large group here of lacrosse players. We had Caleb Trumbull, Cole Talmage, Ellie Barton, Emma Norris, Josh Nardoni, Katie Koenig, Maverick Geller, Rain Melby, Shane Sorensen, Shay Hall, Tara Mickelson, and Wyatt Foley, seniors lacrosse this year.
Woohoo!
Next up is our women's softball seniors.
Seniors, Ashley Crowder, Annika Yasui, Caitlin McNerney, Mackenzie Chambers, and Sam Herring. Coach, tell us about our seniors tennis players.
Our senior tennis players, Anthony Villafana, Ben Fick, Jihan Ziyada, John Hunter, Marilisi Castillo, and Theo McCormick.
And Allegheri Jimenez-Lozano at the very top there.
Uh-oh, I missed one.
All good.
Sorry about that. Okay, now with our last group, our track and field senior athletes.
24 seniors on track and field. That's crazy awesome. Here we go. Aldo Guadarrama, Alessandra Ferrari, Araceli Caravantes, Braden Blakeney, he's going to do track in college, Celia Acosta, Cruz Hawk, Danny Chavaria, Danny Vasquez, Elian Sedano, Francis Dickinson, Jake Page, Josephine Dickinson, Julio Ramirez, Karina Beltran, Laura Lacino, Leo Ledesma, Lottie Brahman, Lucrezia Orlandelli, who went back to Italy already, Lyric Emmons, Mateo Campos Davis, Omar Quintana, Rita Castillo, Zach Polson, and Zeke Smith, all in order by first names. Hey, Eagles, we can't wait to get back on those fields, courts, mats, pools, everything. We need to get playing. I want you guys to keep working out by yourselves and be patient. We will be back. We will be playing soon. We're working on plans for the fall. Coach has a football season all ready to go. We were ordering some gear today and getting ready. What do you want to finish with?
Go Eagles. Stay positive. Let's come back and do this. Here we go.
Go Eagles! Go Eagles! Go Eagles! Woo!
Hey HRV, Coach D here to congratulate your speech and debate team on an excellent year. While we didn't get to have our district and state tournament, we had a full year of wonderful competition before that. 15 team members were seniors and all earned their honor cords through the National Speech and Debate Association Honor Society. Congratulations. In March, the team was named OSAA Les Schwab Team of the Month. Huge congratulations. Two students earned their AAA award, the Academic All-American, from the National Speech and Debate Association this year. Those were Audrey Schlimmer and Jacob Kaplan. Three students are earning their four-year state qualifier award, because even though they didn't get to go to state, they would have qualified 4 years in a row. Congratulations to Grace Skakel, Eric Lizama, and Audrey Schlimmer. And finally, we have two HRV students who will be competing in the National Speech and Debate Tournament. It would have been in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and instead it's going to be a virtual tournament online, but you will be well represented by Jasmine Contreras in Program Oral Interpretation and Sadie Smith in Informative Speaking. Thank you all for supporting the Speech and Debate team and for the fun this year. It's my last year as a coach, and I miss you all in the classroom. Turns out they don't need substitute teachers for distance learning. So I hope you're having a good spring, even though we aren't together. Bye.
Thank you, Delana, and thank you, Mr. Kroll and Mr. Sperry, because he made an appearance as well. We gave Mr. Kroll a 6-minute time window, and he went a little over, but you know what? It was well worth it, so thank you so much. All right, we have had some questions about graduation and prom. So Cole Unger is going to answer some questions about graduation, and Olivia Summerfield is going to talk about prom.
Hello, everybody. It's me, Cole Unger, and I just want to give you an update about graduation. Graduation is going to be on June 5th, and if you're a senior, you should have gotten a letter home discussing the details, but basically we're all going to start at our elementary schools, and we're going to be given times, and then we're going to drive to the high school and do through the graduation ceremony. And it would be awesome if when we're driving by your house, if the rest of you guys would just come out and just cheer them on, whoop whoop. What a year. Thank you for the support. Bye.
Hi, I'm Olivia Summerfield, and I'm the junior speaker of the house. And a lot of people have been asking about prom, so we just wanted to address that. So as of now, based on the phase we're in for COVID set by our governor, we cannot have that many people in a building, so we will not be having prom. But if something changes, it would be August 8th, and we have the date and time set up, so we're just ready to hit the ground running if something changes.
Thank you, Cole and Olivia. All right, I want to let you know about some activities that are coming up. We talked about having a live Kahoot, and rather than live, it's going to be a Kahoot at your leisure. So at the end of this assembly, please make sure you stay tuned for the code, and it will be open at the end of this assembly, and it will close at noon on Monday. And the top winner will get a $25 gift card to Dutch Brothers, and our two runner-ups will get a gift card to Betty's. So please make sure that you're writing your correct name, your correct first and last name, so that we can make sure and get those prizes to the right people. So I will also put the code in Google Classroom and attach it to an email as well. So just be check in for that. Also next week, we have class elections. So the ballots will open at 7:00 in the morning on Wednesday, and they will close at 3 p.m. the next day on Thursday. So watch the videos, watch the election videos, and then please make sure that you are voting. We really need your vote. On Friday, we have our senior assembly. So please, please, please be checking that out. We want to make sure our seniors get some love and get the recognition that they deserve. And also, we want to recognize some staff members that are leaving, either retiring or are leaving the school. So please make sure that you watch that and support our staff and our students. Pretty awesome stuff. Like I said before, Tuffy has his own TikTok. So I am going to let you watch a little bit of that. Thank you, Tuffy, for showing us your moves. Make sure that you follow Tuffy at HRVTuffy on TikTok. And we wanted to, Tuffy's feeling pretty ambitious, and he really wants to challenge the Dalles to a TikTok battle. So the Dalles Riverhawks, if your mascot is ready, we're ready. So hopefully you will accept that challenge. And to all of you HRV students, we miss you. We miss seeing you. We hope that you're healthy and you're safe and you're doing good things. And we want to wish you a wonderful weekend. Happy Memorial Day, and we hope to see you soon. Bye. Mama, you may be 3 years older, but you like